Good morning. Good morning, Joy Gospel Radio family. Good morning, Sister Angela. Good morning. Good morning. God has been good to us, and we are here another morning to give Him praise. The devotional this morning, I titled it Walk on Water or Walk on the Word. Matthew 14:22-33 will be the scripture. And I'm reading from Matthew 14:22. Immediately Jesus made His disciples get into the boat and go before Him to the other side while He sent the multitudes away. And when He had sent the multitudes away, He went up on the mountain by Himself to pray. Now when evening came, He was alone there. But the boat was now in the middle of the sea, tossed by the waves, for the wind was contrary. The disciples were now where Christ sent them, and yet they met with a storm. Sometimes you are in the will of God, but storms come your way. In spite of the storm, they did not try to go back. Going back is not an option. When the children of Israel came to the Red Sea was before them, the Egyptians were behind them. God said to Moses, speak to the children of Israel that they go forward. I tell you this morning, do not look back. In spite of your storm, do not look back. You are not going that way. Jesus said to go to the other side. Now in the fourth watch of the night, Jesus went to them walking on the sea. Jesus left them from the evening. It is now between 3 and 6 a.m., but He comes. When the disciples saw Him walking on the sea, they were troubled, saying, it is a ghost, and they cried out for fear. But immediately Jesus spoke to them, saying, be of good cheer, it is I, do not be afraid. And Peter answered and said to Him, Lord, if it is You, bid me come to You on the water. So He said, come. And when Peter had come down out of the boat, he walked on the water to go to Jesus. But when he saw that the wind was boisterous, he was afraid. And beginning to sink, he cried out, saying, Lord, save me. He was afraid when he saw the wind was boisterous. Fear will paralyze you and stop you from going forward. When you look at the situation you are in, instead of the mighty God who is before you, you stop going forward. This is not the time to look back. Going back is not an option. And immediately Jesus stretched out His hand and caught him. Immediately Jesus stretched out His hand and caught him and said to him, oh, you of little faith, why did you doubt? Why did you doubt that you could walk on your storm? Why did you doubt that God was with you? Why did you doubt that you could not make it? Why did you doubt? When they got into the boat, the wind ceased. Then those who were in the boat came and worshipped him, saying, truly, you are the Son of God. Jesus said to Peter, come. Peter walked on water because of one word. Romans 10:17 says, faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. The word of God causes us to soar above the storm. The word of God causes us to soar above any trial. The word of God enables us to trample on the enemy. The word of God keeps us from becoming overwhelmed by the storm. The word of God gives us victory. Psalms 1:28-2 says, thou hast magnified thy word above all thy name. Is there anybody this morning who is willing to stand on the word of God? John 8:32 said, and you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. 1 John 5:4 says, but whosoever is born of God overcomes the world. And this is the victory that overcomes the world, even our faith. Faith will lead you to believe God for what others think is impossible. The Bible says in 1 John 4:4, you have God little children and have overcome them, because greater is He that is in you than he that is in the world. Romans 8:37 declares, in these things, all these things, we are more than conquerors through Him that loved us. You are more than a conqueror. You win the victory in Christ Jesus. No circumstance or situation can overwhelm you, because you are born to win, to reign, and to rule over circumstances. It's your heritage in Christ Jesus. You're in God's army. As a child of God, you are superior to the devil. The devil and all his demons are under your feet. So walk on water.
Yes.
Walk on the word. Every day, walk with the word. When we walk on water, we are walking by faith and not by sight. Faith in the word that God has spoken. Use the word against the devil's tricks and his schemes. Use the word against the circumstances he uses to distract you. Hallelujah. Use the word against the circumstances he uses to distract you. Do not worry about the storm. Walk on the word. Do not worry about the huge waves. Walk on the word. Do not worry about the high seas. Walk on the word. Do not worry about any negative report. Walk on the word. When you walk on the water of your faith, when you walk on the water of your word, you are getting closer to Jesus. By his strength I am healed. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. God shall fight for me. The battle is the Lord. It is for me. If God is for me, who can be against me? I am walking on the word of God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I am walking on the word of God. Father, we come before you this morning. And we thank you that we can come, Lord God, to you, and we can walk on your word. You give us a word for every circumstance. You give us a word for every situation. And we walk on your word, believing you, mighty God, that you will come through in every situation. Remember those that are sick this morning, those that have some prayer, minister healing to them, God, because you are Jehovah Rapha, the Lord, our healer. Touch, deliver, and set free this morning. Turn situations around, God. Do the impossible, God. Your word says, is there anything too hard for the Lord? You specialize in things seem impossible.
Thank you, Lord.
Turn them around this morning, Father. Work on the behalf of your children in the name of Jesus. Cover Sister Angela. Cover this radio station.
Yes,
we come against the attacks of the enemy.
Yes,
we cancel every plot and plan and scheme in the name of Jesus. Lord, this is your plan for this radio station. So let your plan be established this morning. And let every plot of the enemy, every scheme be destroyed by the fire of Almighty God. In the name of Jesus, cover your servant, God. Put a word in her mouth. Put a word in her spirit. And I want to stand on your word, to walk on your word, to trust in your word, to believe in your word, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you this morning. We give you all the praise, all the glory, all the honor for what you have done, for what you are doing, and what you are about to do.
Yes.
We lift you up this morning, God, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen.